Welcome to Property Reporting Online, our new look online data portal tailored to your property related business activities. Through Property Reporting Online, you will be able to submit an EAS, a re-inquiry, an advice of sale only, and provide the property transaction information the government requires quickly and easily. Entry to the portal is through your existing My Landgate account. Log into My Landgate, navigate to the conveyancer channel, and select Property Reporting Online. This brings you to the dashboard page. There are three summaries on this page which show all the transactions related to your agency. Invitations lists the transactions to which you have been invited. These are property transactions initiated by another agency. Transactions in progress shows your in-flight transactions. They include the transactions you have initiated and the invitations you have accepted. Not matched with dealing are transactions that have gone past the settlement date, have not yet been matched with dealings on the titles register, and require your attention. In this demonstration, I'll show you how an initiating agency submits an EAS involving an Australian sole proprietor on title and Australian incoming proprietors in joint tenancy. As this is a new transaction, select New. Enter the contract details, starting with your own agency file reference number if you use them. Choose the type of transaction from the drop-down menu. In this instance, I am choosing Transfer. Enter the contract date and settlement date from the contract of sale. The settlement date must be within 3 months of the date of EAS submission. Check Resumption only if this applies. Enter the contract sale price as a whole dollar value with no commas or decimal points. And that is all you need to complete on this page for an EAS submission. Select Next or hit the Enter key to go to the next page. Enter the volume and folio and or lot and plan. Do not use prefixes or suffixes such as CT, deposited plan or diagrams. Select the search icon on the right or hit the Enter key. The system generates the land parcel specific to this certificate of title. Tick the checkbox and Add Selected to add the parcel of land to this transaction. This will bring up a row with all the property details, including the lot and plan, street address, and the size of the land parcel. Expand the property by selecting the row. Choose the appropriate land usage at the time of transfer. You may choose multiple usages if you need to. If it is a new building or a residential off-plan purchase, choose that building status. If there is a discrepancy in the address, check Landgate Please Investigate. If you are entering a multi-property transaction, add another property to the transaction by clicking the Add Property icon. All properties in the same transaction must have identical proprietors on title and incoming proprietors, and the interest transferred for each property must be identical. If these values do not match, you will need to submit a separate EAS. Click Next. Confirm the proprietors on title and enter the incoming proprietor details on the proprietors page. If you are acting as the vendor's representative, enter the details of the proprietors on title. In this transaction, you are the buyer's representative, so you enter only the buyer's or incoming proprietor's details. Indicate whether all buyers are going to reside in the house. To enter the buyer's details, select Add Incoming Proprietor. Choose the appropriate entity from the drop-down list under Category. In this demonstration, there are two buyers, both individuals, who are both from Australia, so choose Individual. Enter the details for each buyer separately. In the appropriate fields, start with Surname, then First Name and any other names where applicable, and select Add. Do the same for the second incoming proprietor. In this transaction, your agency is representing both buyers. To indicate this, select the buyers one by one and click the Thumbs Up icon on the right. While the EAS requires you to fill in only the address fields, provide as much detail as you can in the buyer's profile. Select Address Now and enter the address, the street number, street name, suburb, postcode and state. Follow the same steps to complete the future address if that is different from the pre-filled address. Under the postal and billing address, you have a choice. If you choose Managing Agent, you need to provide a contact name and address. If you do not choose As Above, you need to provide a postal or billing address. Follow the same steps to enter the address details for the second buyer. If this is the same as the first buyer, you can choose the Copy Contact Details button, which duplicates the address now, future address, postal billing address, and phone number. Click Next to go to the Invitation for Representatives page. Select the Initiating Agency row to expand the profile and confirm the contact name, email address, and phone number. You can also edit any details here. To invite another agency, click Add a Representative. Choose an agency from the drop box under Agency and then click Add. Select Next to go to the Review and Save page. You can review and edit everything you've entered on this page if you need to. Expand each row to check what you've entered is accurate. If all the information required has been entered, there will be a green tick in the Completed section at the bottom of the page. Check the declaration at the bottom of the page and select Submit to save the transaction. This will not submit your EAS. It saves your transaction and generates a transaction ID. Keep a note of this transaction ID, as you can use it to search for transactions on the dashboard page. Once you have saved the transaction, you'll see a page with a few different options. Expand a row and select the Edit icon on the right. Make your changes and save them by clicking the Save icon on the right. You can revert to your previous data by clicking the Not Save icon. Use the Snapshot button to save a copy of this page as your evidence of completion. At this point, you can cancel or close the transaction. Closing the transaction will take you back to the dashboard page. Click EAS Response to see your inquiries about the status of any EAS submitted. You can use this function only after submitting an EAS. You can submit an EAS re-inquiry to notify the Water Corporation, Department of Planning, and the Office of State Revenue of any change to the settlement date only when one of these agencies has responded. To submit an EAS, click the EAS button, which takes you to the Submit EAS page showing the agency fee. To submit an Advice of Sale Only, tick the Advice of Sale Only box at the top of the page. By ticking this box, you are advising agencies of the change of ownership only and you won't receive rating inquiries. Check the relevant fees for this transaction. You'll find the total fees at the bottom of the page. Click Submit EAS. Once submitted, Landgate will send details to the agencies and it will charge the submitting agency's EBIS account at the end of the month. This also generates an EAS request ID for your records. You can now close the transaction.